On this episode of Aquatic Adventures, we visit the swamps and wetlands of New Orleans and Orlando to explore the structures and behaviors of the... Today, we'll focus on the adaptations, behavior, diet, and conservation of the alligator. Our first stop is New Orleans, home of Mardi Gras, where we're bound to find alligators in the miles and miles of swamps, filled with cypress trees and murky, warm waters. We'll learn about how these adaptations help this organism meet its needs in growth, reproduction, and survival. Specifically, we'll focus on the external adaptations of camouflage, the mouth, legs, and tail of the alligator, and how these adaptations help them survive in this unique swamp ecosystem. Swamps are forested, low-level, sponge-like lands filled with water and covered with trees and aquatic plants. Today, I'll take an airboat tour of the swamp to get a closer look at the alligator and its habitat. The first adaptation I notice is something that's hard to notice. Camouflage. It was pretty hard to spot the alligators because of their skin texture and color that blended in with the environment. This helps the animal go unnoticed when hunting for prey. Take a look. Can you find the alligator in this picture? The next adaptation that you might notice right away is the alligator's mouth. This dangerous mouth is perfect for catching prey. Filled with 80 teeth that are replaced when they're damaged or lost, the alligator can have up to 2,000 teeth in their lifetime. And their jaws shut with 3,000 pounds of pressure. That powerful tail is nearly half of the alligator's length. The tail helps to push the alligator through the water that allows for bursts of speed under the water. The legs, of course, are used for movement. The strong muscles allow the alligator to have quick bursts of speed on land. Their sharp claws are a great adaptation for movement, catching prey, and it helps them to climb from the water up onto the land. These adaptations all together help this animal survive and thrive in the swamp ecosystem. The alligator life cycle is pretty simple. Alligators build nests and they lay eggs. And in the swamp, there are lots of places to build a nest. I was lucky enough to find one and to get a close, but safe look. One alligator behavior is that the females build a mound nest of soil and plant material. They lay an average of 32 to 46 eggs. And after about 68 days, they hatch. Young alligators are eaten by a variety of predators, including raccoons, otters, birds, and other alligators. So another behavior that the mother alligators have to protect their young is to carry them safely to the water in their mouth. Sometimes alligator mothers have another behavior to protect their young. They watch over them for a few weeks or months until they are able to survive on their own. The swamps of New Orleans and travel to the wetlands of Florida to learn more about the alligator and its diet. Welcome to Gatorland, an alligator conservation refuge and park. Here, alligators are fed, kept safe, and looked after while visitors learn about them. After I fed the smaller alligators, I felt it was time for me to feed the big ones. But I wasn't expecting this. No cages? Are you kidding me? Just one park ranger stood between me and certain doom. Before I show you what happened at the feeding, let's explore the diet of the alligator. Alligators are carnivores and eat a variety of animals found in the wetland ecosystem. Alligators get their energy from this food, but how exactly do they get this energy? It works like this. Plants take in the sun's energy, and then small fish take in the energy that was in the plants, and then larger fish take in the energy that was in the smaller fish, and finally the alligators take in the energy that was in the larger fish. The plants produce the energy, and the other animals consume it. The energy from the sun moves from organism to organism. The energy is transferred, or moved, from one living thing to the next. Okay, it's feeding time. Today I get to hand feed the alligators some beef meat. Thank you. Living things affect the physical characteristics of the regions that they live in. One example is how human activities can have major effects on the ecosystem in negative and positive ways. Alligator populations for a while were dropping steadily because of the negative human impact on the environment. Negative human impacts like pollution have destroyed the environment. Humans taking up land and invading the wetland system have caused the alligator to lose hundreds of miles of land. This causes alligators to get lost and have nowhere to go. Due to positive human impacts, alligator populations are on the rise again as individuals and communities do positive things to help protect our Earth's resources and environment. It is important that we all continue to do things to protect the alligator. Today we learned some things about the alligator, but perhaps you can continue learning and visit an alligator conservatory and get a close-up view of these amazing animals.